Hi friends, welcome to this video. In this video, we'll be discussing dockerlab 102, interacting with Docker container. As a step zero, you need to create a Docker Hub account if you don't have it already. On step one, you have an option to scroll down and work, or you can open a new window and work on play with Docker. Once you have the play with Docker window, or you scroll down on this page, click on start. It will start a 4-hour session, click on add new instance, click in the terminal and press enter. In step five, we will be pulling multiple Docker images. Pull command fetch image from Docker registry and save it on your system. In this case, Docker registry is Docker Hub. We will practice changing registry in future labs. Step six is to run command Docker images. Docker image command is used to check images on local system. You can add minus A. It will show all images on local system. You can also use one of the image name and it will show all the tags associated with that image. Step nine is to do Docker image ls. It'll list all images on local system. Step 10 is to run the container with Alpine image and run a command ls-l inside the container. So Docker container run command will start a container and run command in the new container. In this case, our command will be ls-l and we'll get an output in the print. This will run ls-l command in container and print output. Container will exit after running this command. To practice this further, in step 11, we'll be running the container again, and this time we're trying to echo hello from Alpine. In same way, container will run the command and exit. Next command appears to be an attempt to interact with the container shell. But this will not do anything because you're not asking container to hold or be interactive. All you're asking is to run this command and binsh has no output. This will do nothing as container will run the binsh command and exit. Step 13 is where we're going to have an option of int, which is interactive, and terminal. And this time it'll take us to the terminal inside the container. We're also doing echo hello world and redirecting it to a file hello.txt. Type in exit after that. In step 14, we'll run docker container ls, which will not show us any container as our containers have already exited. Run a command docker container ls-a as shown in step 15 to see the container which have already exited. Pick the container where we just saved hello world and run a command docker container start with the container ID. You can use just first 4-digit of container. Full ID is not required. Let's run docker container exec, name of the container ID and ls. And this will show you that the file we created, hello.txt, is persisted even when the container is exited. This will not be true if the container is removed. Let's start. Our session has been started. Let's add a new instance. Click on it and hit enter. Let's pull all the images. As this is a new instance, there's no image on the local. So Docker is pulling images from Docker Hub. Let's check what all images we have. So all the images are available in local now. Let's see if there's any hidden image. Docker images Ubuntu will show Ubuntu images with different tags. Docker image ls act as Docker images. Let's run a container with Alpine image and run a command ls-l. So in this case, a Docker container run has initiated a container and run ls-l command and the container has exited. Let's practice it again. This time we're going to have echo command run rather than ls-l. You can use any command which is acceptable by Alpine or the container image you're using. Let's try to run binsh. It's easy to assume that this will take us to the container shell, but that's not the case. In order to go to container shell, you have to do container run with it. Now you're inside the container. Let's write it to a file, hello.txt. We can check the file has been created. Exit once you're done. If you check the container list, there's no container running right now, but we see a lot of container has been exited. So a minus A option will allow you to see the containers which have been exited. Let's start a container by docker container start command. We don't have to use the entire container ID. We can just use 6F67, which is the first four alphanumeric. In order to run a command inside the container, you can also do exec. This time it lists the hello.txt, which we just created. Once you're done, delete your instance and close the session. Thank you for joining us today. Please like and share this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel for regular updates, and join us on Slack for interactive chat.